Mr. Mr. Peeps, it's Chris Palena, and today, your boy is in a car. Man, I haven't made a car video in years, bro. I remember I used to make rant stories in my car. You know, this is a new car. I haven't shown it off yet. If you guys want to see my new car, my new whip, my new baby, I got this at the beginning of the year, you know, as a reward for my grind and everything. And I just want to say shout out to you guys, okay? But if you guys want to see that, give this a thumbs up right now. And I'm still a little under the weather, so I may sniff a little bit. I may sound like I got some, okay? But today we got a story time. I know you guys miss it. If you are an OG, you probably heard me tell this on stream. You probably heard this before, but this was told when I had no viewers. I mean, I'm saying, like, I'd be surprised if 1,000 of you heard this. This is one of those stories where I thought, this shit right here is just too funny. It's not about me, it's about my friend. I have so many funny high school stories that I gotta tell you guys. I know you guys have been missing the story times, and I'm actually gonna start bringing them back. But before we get into the story, I want to give a huge shout out to my sponsor, Honey.
Honey is a free browser extension that automatically finds the best coupons on the web, so you always get the best prices on everything you buy online. It's really easy, guys. So basically, I'm on eastbay.com. I got some Duke gear because, you know, March Madness coming up. I gotta support my favorite college team. Yes, Duke is my favorite college team. So it's in my cart right now, and I'm looking for the best promo code. All right, so I hit the Honey extension button. It starts finding and testing codes. It literally tests codes to see and find the cheapest and best deal for you. And as you can see, it found one for me. I hit apply, and bam, discount. Easy, simple, let's go. I'm about to cop right now.
Guys, there's no reason for you not to have Honey installed on your internet browser today. I mean, it's free. It just takes 2 clicks to install. And I'll be honest, me and the guys in the house, we all use Honey. So make sure you guys check it out. Click that link in the description. Once again, thank you, Honey, for sponsoring this video. Now let's get to the story time. All right, let me lean back for this one. Let me hold on. All right, so this story takes place in high school. This is a high school story, okay? You guys missed those high school stories. All right, junior in high school, okay? I had a pretty small circle. And within my small circle, I had a very unique group of individuals, all right? These were my best friends in high school. Still to this day, I give them a call here and there. We link up when I'm in town and everything. You know, we were really close. These were my best friends in high school, all right? The name of my friend that I'm going to talk about, this story, I will remember this for the rest of my life. We're going to call him Doodoo. Doodoo was one of those guys where he's your friend. He's your homie. He's that friend that always tries to, you know, kind of one-up everybody, but do it in a kind of humble way. And you know he's lying. You know he's lying. And you're just like, Doodoo, like, you're my friend, bro. You ain't gotta lie to me, bro. I'm your friend. Why are you lying? It's okay. I still think you're cool. If you take an L, you're still gonna be my friend, bro. You don't gotta tell me you bagging all these chicks when we know in reality they not even looking your way. They don't even know who you are. So Doodoo, he was into one of these girls that was on the girls' basketball team that I was pretty good friends with. And we had this kind of brother-sister relationship. That's all it was. We were just brothers and sisters kind of thing. And this girl, name, let's call her BB. BB, she came to me one day and was like, yo,
I kind of like Doodoo. The Doodoo got a girl. And
it's funny you say that, BB, because Doodoo, I think he actually likes you. So the next day, you know, I called up Doodoo and I was like, yo, bro, you gotta make some moves on BB, man. I think she's really digging you, all right? And this may be a little weird, guys. I don't know if y'all do this. I don't know if this was just kind of like my group of friends, my car's turning off. Some of you may even be doing this too. Anytime someone says something at lunch or breakfast, you know what I'm saying, break time, whatever, when we're together and we hear something sus, like someone says like something sus, someone says like, yo, pause, bro. You get these points. You didn't want these points. If you got a lot of points, you sus. Okay, and to get rid of those sus points, even if you complimented a girl, I mean, we'd be like, hey, you know, Doodoo, go say what's up to that girl and we'll take some points off. Cause Doodoo would always say the most sus stuff, man. Just obviously he's trolling, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, so one day Doodoo was on a rampage just saying just really just suspect stuff. Like we were like, bro, you gotta chill. You gotta do something today. And so what I told him, I was like, look, I need you to go up to BB and give her a hug. Alright, just give her a hug. We were running late to class. We're all in the same history class. All of us. I mean, all my homies, Doodoo, me, BB. We all in the same history class. You know, my ass, I didn't really care about being tardy and shit. So I went to the bathroom. I had to pee. We saw BB standing with her group of friends. And we're like, look, Doodoo, just go say what's up to her. I'm gonna go take a piss. Y'all watch. Let me know if he, you know, completes the task by just hugging her, saying what's up, and give her a nice little hug. You know what I'm saying? I go to the bathroom. They go to class. I'm late. I think I ended up taking a shit. I don't know. But I was late, and I come in there. I come into the history class, and all of a sudden, I see my friends just dying. They dying laughing, right? And I'm like, damn, what the fuck is so funny? And then I look over, and Doodoo in his seat, sweating his ass off. Like, guys, when I say sweating, the man was drenched. Like, he just came out of PE. Just straight out of PE and ran to class. That's how drenched in sweat. Like, this man was in a sauna, came out, went to class, didn't have time to fucking dry off with a towel, nothing. He is in class. You see this red hoodie? This shit went from light red to just dark maroon. That's how drenched this man was, okay? And I was so confused. What is wrong with Doodoo, dog? Like, is he good? Like, Doodoo, are you good? These dudes were just laughing, and I'm just so confused. Even the teacher was like, yo, Doodoo, do you need to step outside? Because I'm a little worried. Like, you over here sweating bullets, and class just started. Like, we don't got a quiz today. Your grades are fine, Doodoo. Like, what are you sweating for, my ninja? I look over, and that's when my homeboy is like, yo, why is this dude sweating? And I swear to God, guys, this man was sweating because of the hug. Because of the hug. This nigga was sweating because he hugged a female for the first time. And it gave him that, I guess, just like anxiety through the roof to the point where this man was sweating. They didn't even tell me that. I said no. No, 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 please, please, please. I put the two and two together. I said, wait. Because I know Doodoo, man, and he's a little anxious, all right? He's got a little social anxiety, all right? He's a little shy when it comes to females. And I was like, no, no. And I just burst out laughing, man. Guys, when I tell you top five funniest moments of my life, like, I couldn't breathe. The teacher kicked me out of class because I was laughing so hard, and she wanted to know what the fuck was so funny. And I tried to tell her. She just was like, oh, okay, well, stop disrupting the class. Chill the fuck out. I was on the floor laughing. I couldn't hold it in, dude. I tried. And the man, first dude who got up, he tried to get some paper towels, dap his forehead, and he had to take his hoodie off, man. He had to go to his locker and change clothes. That's how bad he was sweating. Bro, when he came back, we fried the fuck out that boy, dude. I mean, like, he couldn't say a word. I was like,
God damn, nigga, you sweating over a hug?
And then my homies were telling me that it wasn't even, like, one of these hugs. It was a side hug.
A side hug.
And I'm like, dog, if you sweating like that over a side hug, man, we gonna have to call ER if you over here kissing her on the cheek. You get a kiss from her on the cheek, this nigga gonna pass out. Got to go to the ER, need a surgeon. I don't know. He gonna need a doctor for a kiss. Bro, imagine if he just put the tip in, get one stroke. Oh man, he wouldn't survive. But that's pretty much the story, man. Like, that to me, I hope that comes off as funny as, like, it really was. Like, I wish I could just bring that shit to life. Like, if that was a movie, man, or a little skit, like, God, that was so funny. And yeah, and it's funny because I think last time I talked to Doodoo and BB, they actually are together. They are dating, last time I checked, and, you know, they're in a pretty long, happy relationship. They've been together, shit, at least 3-4 years since I've been out of high school. Since I've been out of high school, man. And it's crazy to think, like, that, like, I sparked that. You know what I'm saying? I, like, kind of, you know, shot my Cupid arrow. And look at that. They in love and shit. It's a cute little story. It's a cute little story. And I told BB what happened. And she was, like, kind of turned off by it. Because, I mean, what girl wouldn't, like, you know, if he's sweating over a hug. Like, come on, my nigga. Grow some balls. And, yeah, dude, that happens. If you guys wanted more high school stories, just let me know. I know that one wasn't necessarily about me, but I was involved in that. That's just so funny. Sweaty hugs, man. That boy was sweating. Have you guys ever had an experience like that where a girl that you liked or had a crush on, your first experience with her, you had, like, you took an L, you were mad, awk, and just silent, you know, sweating? And I don't know, dude. I personally That's never happened to me. But anyways, guys, I hope you liked it. Give this a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new. Let me know down below if you guys want more story times. I know you guys love the story times. I need to bring it back. It's just, man, I told so many. But if you guys are messing with the story times and how I told it, just let me know. I'm good with criticism. Hope you guys found this, you know, as entertaining and, you know, funny as I did. But yeah, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new. Join the crew. You already know what to do. Once again, shout out to Honey for sponsoring this video. I'm Christopher London. Peace.